Hi guys, welcome to Puneet's Astrology, your one-stop astro channel. This is your astrologer Puneet bringing you yet another video on another transit, and this time this is going to be Mars transit. Mars is going to have a transit in the sign of Capricorn from 2nd of May 2018 till 5th of November 2018. Why this transit is going to be significant? We will discuss that. What is this transit all about? We will also discuss that. How is this transit going to affect each one of you? Ascendant by ascendant, we will discuss also that. We have already discussed the Rahu, Ketu, Saturn and Jupiter transit. The links are also in the description section below. You can directly watch them there if you want to go to the transit videos of the Rahu, Saturn and Ketu and Jupiter. But why Mars? Mars is the inner planet, right? We all know Mars is Mars stays about 45 days in a zodiac. Why to go with Mars transit? The reason is, first of all, the most important reason is this is going to last for about 6 months. So this is not a short transit. A 6 month transit is always going to affect each one of us in a more significant way than a 45 day transit. Next, Mars is going to be exalted, which adds up to the significance of the process, because for 6 months it is exalted. And out of that 6 months, 27th June to 28th of August, 2 months, it is going retrograde. Exalted and retrograde. What is retrograde planets? What are the effect of retrograde planets? What is the fundamental principle of retrogression? You can also watch that video. The link is in the description section below, or you can hit the iCard here. Now, proceeding with the Mars transit. So why is this transit going to be very significant? There are 3 points. Point number one, which I've told already, it is going to last for a span of 6 months. Point number two, Mars is getting exalted here. The energy is very high. The energy to punch, to make decision, to relive the moment, to do something on your own and to win the battle, no matter what, to do a head-on collision into your problems is going to be your nature in this transit. Whether it will be good or bad, that we will discuss later, that's a different thing. But the fundamental nature of the Mars exaltation is that Mars wants to hold the rank. Mars wants to win. Mars wants to achieve. Now, the third point, which makes it a very, very unique transit. Mars is exalted, but with Ketu. Yes, Ketu is already there in Capricorn and Mars will join Ketu. So it's going to be a Mars and Ketu conjunction in the Capricorn sign. You know, we all know Ketu means already completed karma. Ketu, the symbol of Ketu is a flag and also a headless god. Now, completed karma means the battle has already been either won or lost. What will a military general do in an already decided battlefield? What will he win out of that? Whether Mars and Ketu together give the result of a double Mars exaltation, because Ketu behaves like Mars. So this is going to be a Mars plus Mars. So will it be a cancellation of energy? Or whether it will be an amplification, a sudden outburst of energy? And the answer is, it will be a sudden outburst of energy, but with a fluctuating voltage. This is going to last for 6 months. So it's like your bulb is lighted on for a very long time with a very fluctuating voltage. Because of the Ketu, the sinusoidal waveform comes into picture. The ups and downs will come in the energy. Sometime you will feel very high in energy, and sometime you will feel bloated. Sometime you will feel, I don't want to do anything. Sometime you will feel satisfied, and sometime you will not become satisfied, and sudden switch from satisfaction to dissatisfaction is prominent in this transit. But there is one more hidden aspect. I think you may have noticed. If you have not noticed, let me bring that in front of you. Mars is going in the sign of Saturn. Mars is going in Capricorn. Capricorn is ruled by Saturn. Where is Saturn? Saturn is in Sagittarius, 12th from Mars. What is Saturn doing? Saturn is retrograde. Mars is there. The dispositor of Mars, that means the ruler of the house where Mars is situated, is retrograde. What is so special? Because the house where Saturn is situated, that ruler is also retrograde. Jupiter is getting retrograde. Sagittarius is ruled by Jupiter. So you see a very unique force here. Mars is going in Capricorn, ruler Saturn retrograde. Saturn is in retrograde, Saturn is in Sagittarius, ruler Jupiter retrograde. This is a guided laser beam. This is not a simple transit. This holds extreme significance. There is Rahu aspecting Mars also. So another amplification, a huge volcanic eruption of energy, a single guided beam that will either strike the target or it will be misfired because Ketu is headless, directionless. So if your decision, your compulsive decision, your impulsive outcome, impulsive thought process that you try to pitch in and decide something out of nowhere, if it is a guided one, if it has the direction, if you have channelized that energy properly, it will hit the target, do the job for you. Otherwise, it will have collateral damage. Just like a guided missile going misfired, going in the wrong direction. Even if there is a slightest deviation, it can cause the target to be missed and rather destroying something else. So this simply means that in this time frame of 6 months, you need to be extremely focused on what you decide, extremely focused on what you do, extremely focused on what you are trying to achieve. Your thought process should be extremely focused without any anger, because there is going to be a volcanic eruption, there is going to be anger. But this is the time of the greatest achievement, greatest victory and greatest win. Don't waste it. Don't utilize this actually for the benefit of yourself and not for the misguided attempt and thereby landing up in a collateral damage, thereby ruining your very own pathway that you have created. This transit has the potential to immediately accelerate at the speed of light so that you reach your target in a very fast way, or it will deviate you away from your target in the same speed. And you know, if you are deviated with a faster speed, the distance traveled is very high, and therefore you are deviated by a greater angle. And it might be possible that after the Mars transit goes over, you may regret what you have decided in this transit. This transit involves extreme thought process. This transit demands extreme thought process. This transit demands extreme attention. This transit demands low risk-taking capacity. This transit demands always you should have a plan B with you. This transit demands you cannot decide anything out of anger. And this transit demands extreme confidence, but a check on overconfidence. Mars and Ketu is going to create a sinusoidal wave pattern of energy. We all know Rahu Ketu is a sinusoidal wave pattern. Sometimes it goes up and periodically it goes down, then periodically it will go up. Therefore, same will happen with your energy. It will be a fluctuating one. You don't have a stabilizer here to stabilize that fluctuation. So you have to accept that fluctuation. Utilize the time when you are very high in energy and rest at the time when you are low in energy. It does not matter that you get frustrated when you are not able to do anything, because when you are low in energy, you will try to do, because Mars is there, wants to achieve the rank, because it is the sign of Capricorn, which is the 10th sign, which is the sign of rank, designation, profession, career. Mars wants to achieve something. Mars wants to achieve. He wants to get it. Ketu says, you have already achieved that. What else do you want? Mars will say, I want something extra. Person will go a step ahead. You will decide beyond your reach. Be very careful. If you are trying to accomplish a task beyond your feasibility, you will fall flat on your face. This Mars will be like running like a child who has just learned to walk. The moment he starts running, after a few steps, he will fall on his face. I don't think this transit is a transit where you are going to take huge risk. Try to avoid taking risk. Try to mitigate the risk as much as possible. Plan your things. Be like a military soldier. None of the battlefield in history we have seen is fought without planning. You also have to plan the battle of your life with proper planning. And therefore, an exalted Mars is there, ensuring a win. Remember, exalted Mars ensures a victory of the person, provided the person follows the disciplinary principles and righteous path. Because Mars is going to be on the house of Saturn, remember, it is going to be aspected by Rahu for the entire period when the Mars is in the sign of Capricorn. Rahu is going to be in Pushya Nakshatra. That is a benefic aspect of Rahu strangely benefic because Rahu is a malefic, but Rahu is giving a nourishment transit, nourishment aspect on Mars. So this amplification of that energy is going to be very, very powerful, especially the spiritual upliftment of life. Because Mars and Ketu is the spiritual energy, Rahu's aspect and Saturn retrogression with Jupiter retrogression, immensely spiritual. So if everybody of us will feel that spiritual force awakening, we will feel that spiritual awareness in us, and we will feel the God connection among us. We should not try to misguide ourselves. We should not try to deviate our attention. We should try to be spiritual. We should try to be righteous, and we should try to utilize and harness this energy. What happens when there is a surge of electricity? You try to protect the appliances. Similarly, if whenever there is a surge of energy, try to protect your body, try to dissipate that energy through exercise, through pranayama, through yoga, through running, walking, doing some physical activity. And whenever you are low in energy, what you should do? You should try to recharge yourself. Don't become sad, because you will be sad for a week. You will run here and there. But again, after a week, you will feel a sudden rise in energy, and you will feel frustrated. Because you will feel, what is actually happening with me? Today I am very much energetic, tomorrow I am not, then again I am energetic, then again I am not. How should I decide? My take here is, accept this fact. Accept the fact that there is going to be ups and downs of energy, there is going to be a fluctuation. Try to stabilize yourself. This is the time where you stabilize, and one who stabilizes itself is going to win, simply. Because Mars is exalted ultimately. Mars is doing what he wants, and since this exaltation happens for 6 months, very rare this for the inner planets, exaltation happens for 6 months, this is ensuring victory. If not today, then tomorrow. All you need to do is understand the nature of your planet, understand the nature of your anger, control your anger, control your emotions, control your vibrations of your mind, and try to focus your attitude. This is the time where you immensely focus on the object and work one object at a time, target it out, set up your priorities, because this is all about planning your life. You have to set up your priorities. There is no other way. Mars will help you, and try to strike off all the tasks. Check. Try to check all the unchecked tasks that you wanted to do, but without being angry, without being hesitant, without doubting yourself, without having overconfidence, without believing in all the other nuances, all the other nonsense of the world. Try to have faith in yourself. Mars will instill that faith in yourself. This is going to be a blessing, provided you take it as a blessing, and don't become overconfident because of this. Don't cross the feasibility line. The moment you cross the feasibility line, it will not work. Ketu will come into picture, it will not let anything work. Yes, in the first few months, in the first 4 months, you may face a bit of difficulty. You may face the heat of Mars. You will feel angry. You would like to take revenge. You would like to be somebody. Take it positively, take it actively. So once Mars tries to reach Capricorn at 28 degrees, Mars crosses the degree of Ketu. Ketu becomes in the lower degree. So now, Mars uses the energy of Ketu, the spiritual energy of Ketu, and tries to amplify that energy. So somewhere around starting October till the starting of November, that 1 month is going to be very positive. For the 2 months which Mars is going to be retrograde, try not to invest something, especially in the property, especially in the area of electronics, especially in the area of energy sector. That is going to fluctuate a lot. Because Mars is getting retrograde, retrograde Mars is that Mars means his rank is getting diminished. So he is now more focused. He will try to do tasks which are beyond its reach. So will we. We may lose something, or we may feel we are losing some ground. We may feel we are losing our rank, and because of which our attention, our work, our energy will furthermore enhance, furthermore increase, and our will to act will also increase. But we be very careful. This will to act, if increased in a positive sense, will give you positivity, will increase. If increased in negative sense, will burn you out. Don't burn yourself. There is no use. Mars is going to be there for 6 months. After that, Mars will move to Aquarius. Aquarius is an air sign. Mars effect on Aquarius is extremely different than it is in Capricorn. The original first house and eighth house lord is getting exalted of the Kalpurush, because Mars rules Aries and Scorpio, the first and the eighth house. So obviously, if the first house is getting exalted, that means your desires are getting exalted. Your desires will increase. You want more. You would like to achieve. You would like to explore yourself. That is a very good thing. But also the 8th house energy is increased. So occult energy is increased. Uncertainty is also increased. Try to hold the ground where you are standing and remember one thing. Understanding your own energy signature is going to be very important. If your body does not allow, don't overdo. This is the key mantra in this transit here. Do not try to overdo and overexert and overburn yourself. You have a 5000 milliampere battery phone, but don't try to drain it in 5 hours. Then there is no point of having such high battery phone. You have this energy capacity, the higher energy capacity, so that you can work longer. So your tasks are getting executed as per your will. Utilize it wisely. This energy can be constructive, can be destructive. Totally depends upon you. How do you take it? How do you push it? How do you channelize it? How do you channelize the electricity in the wiring? It all totally depends upon how you attach the connections of your life. So this transit hopefully will help you all. This was a general explanation. Let us go ascendant by ascendant and understand what this transit is going to bring for Aries till Pisces.